Jeremiah Smith, a University of Kentucky biologist, works closely with his colleague Randall Voss on sequencing the salamander genome.
The salamander genome is really big. It's 10 times bigger than the human genome, even though it probably contains essentially the same genes as the human genome. There are lessons that can be learned about how organisms deal with all the DNA they have by looking at this extreme example in salamander. So it can provide important perspective on what the ancestral genome looked like.
Like salamanders, sea lamprey can regenerate their spinal cord.
And they'll repair their spinal cord, and in 5 weeks, the animal can swim perfectly. We think that this unique biology of lamprey can sort of allow us a handle into identifying those specific cell types that are maybe set aside that permit regeneration. The overarching goal is to begin to bring some of what we learn to application in human healing, your human injury and repair. And it's sort of always been the goal. It's been the goal for probably close to a century. We know these animals can heal. We'd like to figure out how so that we can heal better. You can think of this as like several baby steps too, in terms of identifying some of the factors that allow cells to create these special undifferentiated cell types that promote regeneration. You have billions of cell divisions, and all the cells sort of by and large do what they're supposed to do. And understanding that complexity of life, that is really motivating to me, to be able to appreciate how life does what it does. One of the reasons why I like these genomes is because I just love the sort of paleontology of it. If I had my choice of a career and didn't have to think about paying for medical school and all that stuff, I would probably be a paleontologist and like dig for fossils. But really, the genomics is almost as or more pleasing than that, because accessing the genomes of these animals, describing them, and then comparing them with other genomes that have been sequenced, you're often the first person to know sort of what was going on, you know, half a billion years ago. It's sort of like, you know, the kid in the dinosaur museum thing.